published in 2013, and then the second book is China Rich Girlfriend, and the third book is Rich People Problems. So, if you're worried about the fate of the characters in this book, there are two more, so more happens. I had never heard of this book before, and I actually decided to pick up and read it because I found out about the movie that's coming out August 17th, 2018. And it stars the actress who plays this Jessica Huang in Fresh Off the Boat. I love that sitcom. I absolutely adore it, and Jessica is my favorite character on that show. So when I found out that she was going to be in a movie, in the movie theater, I have to go and support that. But first, of course, I have to read the book. So, the book. We have three main characters. There is Nicholas, Rachel, and Astrid. Nicholas and Rachel are dating, and Astrid is Nicholas's cousin. Now, as you can probably tell from the title, Crazy Rich Asians, this is about very wealthy Asian people. Nicholas and Astrid are both very wealthy. Nicholas is currently living in New York, working as a professor and dating Rachel, and they're living together. Rachel has no idea that he is filthy rich. Like, he does not live as if he's wealthy. He, you know, doesn't have multiple houses and wears different designer clothes and all that. So she has no idea about his life, like, his family's lifestyle. And he hasn't told her. His family lives over in Singapore. And they're, you know, the very wealthy to-do. But his family's kind of, like, under the radar. They have a lot of money and nice things, but they don't go around flaunting it everywhere like some other families do. So that's also another reason that Nicholas isn't kind of like, I'm rich, because he wasn't raised that way. Nicholas' best friend, Colin, is going to be having a wedding. He is getting married to Araminta. And Nicholas has been invited, and he's allowed to bring an extra person. So he asked Rachel if she would like to go to Singapore and spend the summer with him, as well as attending his best friend's wedding. And she's like, sure, why not? Well, when she gets there, she discovers that this isn't the vacation that she was expecting. Her best friend, who she already knew was rich, kind of like lavishes upon her and buys her things. And when she finds out that Rachel is dating this really wealthy guy, she's like, well, you're going to have like top-of-the-line clothes, and you're going to have to get pedicures and manicures, and we're going to have to do this and that, you know, to keep up with everybody else and impress his family and everything. And then she also finds out that his best friend, Nicholas's best friend, is super rich. And his wedding is like the event of the year. This is like when Meghan Markle and Prince Harry got married. This is huge. Everyone's talking about it. Everyone wishes that they could attend, and a lot of people are going. And Rachel kind of gets swept up into this, like, wealthy lifestyle, and she gets to go to the bachelorette party where, guess what, all of these other rich girls are jealous that she, poor little Rachel, who is nobody and comes from no name, it has one of their eligible bachelors. So she kind of gets harassed and picked on in, like, the snobby way. It's not like a direct picking on. You have to kind of, like, pick it up because that's what they're doing and kind of putting her down. And Rachel is not happy about it. And then we have Astrid, who is very wealthy. She's, like, the fashion icon. Everyone is worried about what she's wearing, what she's doing. She's pretty much like a Kardashian. Like, people want to know about Astrid. Well, she finds her husband's cell phone and finds a disturbing message that makes her believe that he is cheating on her. And throughout the book, you kind of see him drifting away from her and coming up with excuses about why he can't go to events, he doesn't go to the wedding, and, you know, Astrid is kind of very distraught about what's her husband doing. she believes that he's cheating on her because what other reason could there be that he would not be wanting to spend time with her? So, really good. They said it was funny, but I didn't really laugh that much. It's more of a satire funny, which I, you know, isn't like ha ha ha. So I didn't really laugh that much, but I was like really engrossed, and especially with Astrid's story. I was like, oh my goodness, what's going on? What's her husband doing? Like, ah! Like, I really liked Astrid. But yeah, you should check these out, and also check out the movie when it comes out in August, because I am really excited, and I can't wait to read the next two books. And I hope you all have a wonderful day. Bye-bye.